Cynthia Perna, actually, and I'm one of the co-founders of Anir Nester, along with my husband, Vince, who's over there. That's it. I'm one of the co-founders, and here we are today. The brand was established because I think we've always had, I know we've always had this passion for fashion and to have our own company and see it through. And the name really comes from my grandmother, in Italian, it's called Nonna, who her name was Esterina. So when you kind of reshuffle the letters, you get Anir and Esther. And she was a couturière from Italy, and we immigrated to Montreal. And I grew up with her washing fashion and having the passion for it. And that's how this got established. It's a very interesting story, probably one that's too long for any one interview. But we essentially came up with this concept and we decided to follow it. But we are actually management consultants for big firms as a full-time job and have done this as a supplement. So there's a little brief. Looking at a preview of these three pieces as we're starting off. And I don't know if you can see them through that camera, but we have three different pieces that we're really trying to focus on the woman. And kind of have the woman as the femme fatale, but not in the sense to seduce a man. That's not the goal. The goal is to really for a woman to seduce the world with her power and her beauty and her energy and her intelligence and all that comes with it. And that's why you'll notice that the dresses themselves, and actually not only the dresses, the pieces, aren't all the same, because a woman is never necessarily always the same. We can't put someone into a mold. The strong woman in that sense, or the woman who's going out to battle to take her position in the world, to do what she has to do. But then we go on to this black dress here, which talks about fluidity and the freedom, all while being empowering and talks really here about the elegance and simplicity. And I think you'll notice on this gown, one of our trademarks, which will be the twist and the cape, because, you know, women are heroes and heroes do wear capes. And you'll notice some feather work on this dress as well here. And that was done with our feather master and collaborator, Eric Charles Donatien. He has just become our guardian angel in this world of fashion, and we adore him. And he has a belt made from the rooster feathers of the neck of the rooster, right? So here we see that the lines are clean, it's all cut on a bias, and it's really for to show the empowerment of the woman while being something so fluid and so simple. So that's the elegance and simplicity. And then we can go here to the other dress on the right, on the left hand side. This is the suit, right? With the the 2.5 kilos of the crystals, which is all hand embroidered. And, you know, I wouldn't be able to even tell you how many hours were spent doing all this, because when you love something, you don't really count the hours. And then in this third piece, this again, the feather work comes from Eric Charles Donatien. He is, as I told you, the feather master premier of the world. And these are ostrich feathers that have been individually placed on. And this dress talks about, again, the fluidity and the freedom, all the while holding a bit of the structure, right? Because it's really too tapered to the body. And we've used here silk, all garments and fabrics from Italy. So that's a little bit of it. There you go.
Céline Joudard, je suis l'organisatrice et la fondatrice de l'Oriental Fashion Show. Donc c'est un événement qui a lieu à Paris deux fois par an pendant la haute couture, où on présente divers créateurs qui viennent du monde entier. Actuellement, nous sommes présents à Paris deux fois par an, à Londres, nous sommes présents dans 10 pays, dont la Russie, l'Azerbaïdjan, le Kazakhstan, le Maroc aussi, et on souhaite élargir notre plateforme à d'autres pays, et nous souhaitons aussi promouvoir des designers français dans ces pays-là ou européens. Actuellement, l'organisation compte 120 designers en 105 et à peu près une cinquantaine de nationalités. Récemment, on a eu un grand événement au Carrousel du Louvre où 20 designers ont pu présenter leur collection haute couture, et nous étions vraiment ravis de l'accueil que le public parisien a fait à cet événement et à ses créateurs. Ces créateurs sont venus d'Asie centrale, du Tadjikistan, Kyrgyzstan, aussi d'Azerbaïdjan, de Turquie, du Maroc, du Liban, de l'Égypte. Et parmi nous, on compte de grands créateurs comme Hanil Bahiri, Abed Mahfoud, Slava Zaitsev, Saher Okal. Il y a vraiment des noms extraordinaires et on les remercie de nous faire confiance. Et aussi, je les salue. Je salue aussi Jamal Taslak, qui est venu de Milan. Je remercie tous les designers qui étaient parmi nous. Cette saison de prêt-à-porter à Paris est particulière parce que nos designers présentent aussi leur showroom à Paris et nous sommes vraiment contents de l'évolution de leur travail et surtout de leur position sur le marché de la mode. Et ça nous rend fiers et au moins notre travail est utile pour faire perdurer leur entreprise et leur travail. Vraiment des collections merveilleuses et ça évolue dans le bon sens et on est vraiment très contents. Parce que Paris reste quand même une plateforme de mode qui est ouverte à tout le monde. Et ça, c'est extraordinaire.